What is going on, everybody, and welcome back to more NECC Valorant. Two new casters in the booth. It's going to be Septilins here with Jag, and now we've got UC Davis versus Montclair. And if it's anything like the game that just ended on stream before this one, we've got quite the match ahead of us.
Absolutely. That last one, it did go to three maps, but here's actually a bit of a story of revenge, as these two teams have not played in their regular season, but they did play in the preseason, with Montclair State falling short in that matchup. Montclair State also, we've seen them a few times, but you and I have cast them as well. They have yet to win in the regular season just yet. You see Davis too. They are on a 2-1 record, so not too bad, not too shabby, only one loss. So for Montclair, there's a lot that they need to get done here to try to get back into this regular season.
Absolutely. Like you said, things are looking a little bit bleak. There's not a win in regular season. And then our other team only 2-1. So nobody going exactly perfect, but 2-1 is a lot better than not a single win in that category. So definitely a good place to look out. We're going to be starting on Ascent, and I believe we're going to be having Montclair on the offense and UC Davis on the defense. And then that will, of course, swap for our second and possibly even third map. But honestly, I mean, a new character was introduced. I don't know if we're going to be seeing her at all today, but I feel maybe we're not going to. But this is a competitive scene after all, and maybe nobody wants to be taking that risk quite yet.
Yeah, I was actually wondering about that as well. I mean, Astra just got announced. She just got released today, I believe. So she's brand new to the game. And I think one thing that you and I have talked about a few times is having a controller who has smoked as a main ability, because Omen and Brimstone, that's always been the go-between. Omen has kind of been leading the charges of late. And then they just introduced Astra, who looks like she could really change the game. But, you know, I feel like teams aren't going to be taking risks with her just yet.
Right, I definitely agree. And it sounds like, yeah, we're getting that confirmed now, is that she will be banned for a little while. So that gives people plenty of time to learn her, because I feel like picking her right now would be not really good for either team, because you know nobody's going to be comfortable on an agent that came out like this morning. So we're definitely going to be seeing that stall come out a little bit. So until week six, we're probably going to see that same meta that we've really been seeing recently.
Yeah, which has basically been Omen, and then Phoenix, Jett, Cypher, Killjoy, and then, you know, we get a mix in between. So we go into Ascent. We're going to figure out exactly what these teams want to run. This is Montclair State's choice. And as you said, UC Davis 2 is going to be on the defense first, as they get to choose sides. They chose Bind later on. And I feel like we always talk about Reyna. So if Divine does choose to go that route, I'm very interested to see how that turns out for them. But oh my, Ally C on the Viper.
Yeah, not locked in quite yet. We see them hovering over it, at least for the time being. And now, I mean, we're just currently looking at UC Davis. They're going to be picking exactly what we talk about. And Divine is going to choose to go for that Reyna as well. Going to swap from Ally C. It looks like they're going to go onto the Omen instead of that Viper. And now, yep, no surprise on either side. I guess the biggest surprise would be Riggs on the Brimstone. You see him pretty often, but I feel as of late, we've been seeing him a little bit less in Omen, a little bit more.
Yeah, I mean, we've talked about this, I feel like, time and time again, how Omen is a little bit less powerful and Brimstone is a little bit more powerful, but I feel like Omen just gets so much more value out of the paranoia, anything that you find right now, unfortunately, in Brimstone's kit. Molly can be great, but it's just not enough. And I feel like when you use his abilities to, like, that helps you fire a bit faster, the stimp beacon just does not get enough placement. It doesn't get enough value, because you have to be pretty careful about where you play around it. Omen, meanwhile, it can, you know, just go a lot of different places. Short distance teleport, long distance teleport. A lot of great things coming out of that kit. So we'll see which controller gets the advantage early on. I mean, I think the Breach is going to be really interesting here.
I agree.
I feel like you could run a Sky in the same place instead, because then you'd have some heals, but they're going to try just to go for all that stun, all those concussions. And since they're on attack first, that could actually work out really, really well for them. As you see, they're setting up for B, so I would not be surprised if they immediately go for a flash and just run onto B and try to plan it early on.
Yeah, so not only did they go for the Killjoy, who's got more aggression on the attack than a Cypher would, they also go for that Breach, like you said. So there's going to be a lot of damage coming out from them very quickly on. And yeah, looks like we're just going to be storming B, but Riceman able to pick up that first kill on this wall. Dominus wrecked, Riggs not far behind. Killjoy already on the side of our defense, just absolutely ripping this team apart. And Divine is able to pick up Riceman. We see the lead still very much in favor of UC Davis. And as that fifth and final player is ripped apart from Montclair, it's going to be a great start. First round already in favor of UC Davis too.
It was just a very clean round. I just don't think the attack was, planned out well enough, honestly. It just seems like they ran in and then didn't really know how to reset after that. They lost a few along the way. I mean, you keep your Reyna alive, but we talk about how she doesn't have the same clutch potential that we used to see from her. So it's a great defense early on from UC Davis, too. I'm wondering what's going to happen here. Willie does have that Ares, and I think we know exactly what the plan will be of that. Just going to spam away. And unfortunately for them, there's going to be no one to be met there, as everyone else is on A.
Yeah, I mean, had they been able to do that in the pistol round, which obviously they couldn't have, but I mean, that would have been a 5K had that play followed through quite like they wanted it to. We see the rotation onto A, however, so the attacker is going to get a little bit... We might even see a plant this time, so already looking better than that pistol round. Swildominus Wrecked finds the plant early on, and now all we have to see is a good off or a good defense now, I guess, from Montclair. So a bit of a flip. Montclair now going to be defending the point that they've planted the spike on, and UC Davis, they got to find one kill and just push in like crazy.
Looks like they've already found that kill as... I believe one just fell to the shock dart.
Yeah, it looks like it was the breach. Very unfortunate. That was a wrong place, wrong time, I guess. And we see him taken out. We see a great Paranoia coming through as well. I believe we saw Paranoia for a moment there. Ionly Vain gonna find one. Riceman gonna find another. Flumies and Swildominus Wrecked taken out. It's gonna be Riceman with the ghost again, finding just a bunch of eliminations. And there is not a bunch of time, but definitely enough time to defuse here. It's gonna be another round win and a flawless one at that for UC Davis.
And that's really all you can do on the side of Montclair State with what you've got. I mean, you're just going to go for classics. You know you're not going to have the superior firepower, so you just run into a point. This time you actually do get the spike plant, which helps your economy later on. So it's, you know, you don't get kills, but you get more money, and now you can go for your bonus round. Now you can buy. You're going to get five vandals for the attackers. This could work out really well, and as long as they don't run into that Ares that we saw Willy try to get value out of last round, this could be the first round win going for Montclair.
Yeah, they've definitely got a little bit of economy. They did go for some buys last time around, but they're still able to just barely just make it out from underneath. So actually, they have no economy. The most they have is 300 credits online. And now, I mean, we're just seeing a good lead building for UC Davis 2 here. I think we see some great progress. And in Montclair, they're really going to have to... They're going to have to find at least a couple of eliminations here because they have one elimination in total for the whole team right now.
Yep, Alice, just going to... spam away, gonna be caught out a little bit. They had the Spectre versus Vandals. It's not a matchup you want to take, and it looks like they're gonna go for the same exact rotation, but Alicy able to take out Flumies. That's huge right now for UC Davis.
Yeah, Alicy, they just poke their head around the corner, find Flumies on the high ground, who definitely was not paying attention there, and they're able to take out the jet. So, you know, one of those people you expect to be those top fraggers gonna be taken out right away, and UC Davis, they have that lead once again.
Have the lead, but can they get the position back?
There it is. Riceman going to be taken out, but Ali C and Ionly Vain, they're able to get rid of two eliminations. And Swildominus Wrecked going to be able to tie things up for just a moment. No, excuse me, it's only going to be a 2v3, but Willy picks up Swildominus Wrecked, and now it comes down to Riggs on that Brimstone, who has yet to get an elimination of his own, but he finds two. Willy is, however, going to be able to take him out with that Ares, and all of a sudden, that's going to be a third round win, it seems, for UC Davis.
Yeah, the spike doesn't go off, and you see there is kind of the power of Brimstone, able to use the Molly to get the Omen off the spike by the means of killing them. I mean, it's a smart play. Like, you go for the half defuse, definitely. I get that, but like, I feel like you just gotta have to run. You gotta realize, like, you're not gonna live through that. Still gives their life for the cause, still gets the round win, so that bonus round does not go the way of Montclair. And like you said, they had very little after trying to go for the full buy last time. Now they're gonna have nothing. They're gonna have to go for Ghosts. And now, because of that big round win for UC Davis, they can go for the full by themselves. Look, things are looking good if you're from UC Davis, too.
Yeah, they are on the up and up, to say the very least. And we talked about Montclair. They do not have a win online quite yet. And now maybe we're starting to see why just a little bit. Their plays, just a little bit, a couple of misplays here and there. Their separations, their approaches just aren't working out. And they always lose somebody early on in that approach. So if they are able to get through onto point with all five, I think we could really see so much better progress. But there it is once again. Divine going to be taken out. Flumi's not far behind. And Swildominus Wrecked, I mean, getting two eliminations now. Riceman, however, the turret able to find it. And Riceman on a solo rampage all once again. Gonna be up to Riggs, a 1v4, and that's seemingly impossible with just a pistol on hand. Ionly Vain able to find that elimination, and that is the fourth round win for UC Davis.
What surprises me about this is because, like, there is so much entry potential for Montclair State's composition. We've already talked a lot about the Breach. We've already talked a little bit about the Reyna and her Leer. So, like, there are a lot of utility that they can use to get onto the point, cut off sight lines. And it seems like instead they're just running in blindly. You saw their Divine was leading the charge, ran in, didn't Leer once, just immediately turned around and got completely shot in the back. So they're just not playing it right. I think that they could try to come back from this, but early on... UC Davis too, they're in control, and see an Op versus an Odin, two interesting gun choices there.
Yeah, especially this early on when you're Montclair sitting at 0-4, to bring out the Operator would be quite an interesting play, to say the very least. I think that Flumies is really gonna have to make this pay off if they wanna. They're gonna have to get at least one kill, which they have yet to be able to do. The only kills on the side, actually three people on the side of Montclair, do have some eliminations under their belt, and Flumies gonna be taken out by Ali C. So that Operator, just, you're handing it over to the enemies here. Yeah, Joe Honey able to pick it up right away. Riggs able to find two kills, however, so the Operator once again gonna be on the ground, and all of a sudden Montclair, they might have this one in the bag.
operator was just a bait the whole time. They were just trying to set it up, but now Ryzen trying to bring it back. It's only going to be Willy with that Odin. And I mean, if there's a will, there's a way. Willy does have 6 assists and 5 kills, so a lot of KD participation, but they know exactly where that Sova is going to be coming from. He does have the Hunter's Fury, but it doesn't really make sense to use it in this situation. So I think at this point, your team economy is pretty good. Just go for exit frags. It's okay if you lose one round early like this.
Yeah, I definitely agree. Go for the exit frags. Try to get some guns out of their hands because, well, you did buy a rather expensive gun. It's not the most expensive in-game, and it looks like, you know, you've got the credits to afford it next round as well. So maybe try to put a little bit of pressure on there. Try to find something valuable, but Willy going to go in. He's going to try to find those exit frags, but he's going to get cornered out. Soul Dominus Wrecked is able to pick up that elimination, and they're going to put the first round on board for Montclair.
Yeah, I don't like that play at all from Willy. I mean, I get it. You want to try to beat the hero. You want to try to save the round, but you're just going to get pincered, and you saw what happened. Right. They had someone on the flank, then you're looking to your right, and there's someone coming in from tree. There's just so many angles you have to try to cover there, and none of them are going to be in your favor. So that is going to be one round going back to Montclair State. They also get to keep the operator, but now we're going to see Joe and try to pick up their own ops. This is going to be the first op v op battle we've seen in this matchup. It's the Jets who are both rocking them. You love to see it because they can go for the dash reset Zeppelins. And this is what I want to see. I want to see these sniper rifles go off.
Absolutely. And something also to note is the two holding onto the operators are both have the least amount of eliminations on their team. So this will be interesting if maybe they've just been holding off the operator and hoping that that's the kind of weapon they're good with constantly and they know how to use. And yeah, Joe able to find an elimination on the Divine straight away. So a great lead already for UC Davis. LEC picking up Flumies, the operator offline once again, finds Riggs as well with the headshot. So they are just on fire right now, already a 5v2 in favor of UC Davis.
One thing to talk about Joe's, like, I think that was like a walking body shot right there. Is that was actually the Empress that was online from Divine. So that's an ultimate that was thrown right down the drain. It's not going to be online for quite a while. And now it's a 5v2. There isn't much you can do if you're Soul Dominus. So you do have the lockdown, but unless you get a kill, now it's just over.
Never mind.
Yeah, forget anything I was going to say. Yeah.
You have the lockdown, but when you turn the corner and just get your head taken off, the lockdown hardly matters. That's another flawless round there for UC Davis, and we're only on round 7 coming up.
Now I'd love to see some of that aggressiveness come out from Montclair State. They've really, I mean, we talked about how they haven't had the potential for using their entry abilities yet. I don't think you use them this round because it's a light buy, but you have Rolling Thunder, you have Lockdown, you have Orbital Strike. All those are great ways to clear areas of effect or, you know, use them as recontests. So use one at the beginning, use one of the other ones later on. It doesn't really matter which order, not this round, but next round. Try to just win this one thrifty. Try to get something back because right now you're down 4 rounds and already it's looking like UC Davis will have a lead going into halftime.
Yeah, I mean, they realistically only have to win 2 more rounds, which they've won 5 out of 6, so they very clearly have a great win rate coming out. And Joe gonna try to find an operator kill. He doesn't pull the trigger quite yet. He's got some great trigger discipline there, knows that he can't get the elimination, but now, you know, he's fingers crossed he's able to find something here as this fight opens up.
Yep, looking for that fight to open up right now. It is 1-1. The run it back, going to be committed. Already going to take down that Killjoy. She is offline for good. The spike already being dropped. Man, I only Vayne has just crushing it right now. 2 kills with the run it back. Now going to be able to come back online with their regular life. The Blazestorm hasn't committed on the other side. It's not what's going to take down Ali C. It's going to be Divine with the Spectre as they continue to roll. And it's a 4v3. Oh, that's an interesting hot hands from I Only Vayne. It's a 4v3, but they just damaged their teammate a little bit.
Yeah, that was weird. I think a move of desperation that was kind of keep myself alive. Didn't really consider that maybe taking out the teammate as well. They take a little bit of damage. They definitely get out on time, but Willy able to pick up Divine. A 3v4 turns into a 2v4, and all of a sudden Montclair looking definitely rough. I Only Vayne committing that firewall super early on, and Riggs and Flumies, I mean, as Flumies is taken out, I Only Vayne trying to find that 4k. They've already found 3. Riggs gonna be able to pick up the Phoenix. I mean, a 9 health Brimstone in a dream. Yeah, something tells me he's not coming out of this one.
Just great plays there by that Phoenix player, I Only Vayne. I love that name, by the way. A great reference to League of Legends, but able to get 3 kills there, 2 of them off of the run it back. So committed that very early on, did a very aggressive defensive maneuver there to be able to go on the fly. It seems like they honestly swapped sides from the angles they were playing.
Yeah.
Vayne was on the defense there. And now, as we saw, the lockdown worked out really well for UC Davis too. So now I want to see it work out just as well for Montclair State. I think use Rolling Thunder first and then lockdown afterwards. Maybe save our Bolt Strike for another rainy day. But, you know, how many rainy days do you have when you're already going to be at best tied going into halftime?
Yeah, I mean, that's a great way to put that. How many rainy days do you have left when you're already down by 5 matches? I mean, this is a rainy day if I've ever seen one. The operator still online for Joe, but it's gonna be, never mind. Okay, just kidding. Haha. Divine is gonna be able to find that headshot kill onto Joe straight away. And we've seen some pretty decent successes from Montclair, especially when they find that first elimination. They're really able to thrive. And as Divine almost finds another one, that would have been huge for them. But LEC is gonna pick up that kill. And now Riggs knows somebody's around that corner and he knows they are low, but just patiently waiting. Gonna, oh, okay, good reaction time. Almost taking out Riggs with the double there. Great flick onto Iron Vane. And like I said, Montclair, they really start to shine when they get that first elimination. Now they just have to keep up that momentum, but as they lose to Dominus Wrecked, things could be bleak.
They get the spike back. That's the biggest thing that they have to commit a Brimstone Smoke just to do, so they know exactly where at least one of them is, which is Rice, man. And right now, if you're UC Davis T, you still have your Silva ultimate, so you could try to play an off angle with it, but then the risk there is that you're gonna, you know, you can just get run up on, because once you're in the Hunter's Fury, like, you can't really do much. But in the meantime, I don't think taking Heaven is the way to go. They
Agreed.
Have a pretty good idea of where you are, and now that you've got the Recon Bolt online, it's not going to find anything, so you're kind of left in the dark here.
Oh, but Flumies lets his guard down for a moment, was not trained on Heaven, but I definitely agree. Oh, never mind, Dingo Baby's going to win it there, a 1v2. But as Raceman took Heaven, I mean, you just followed the most likely path for you to follow. Like, you were really falling into a trap there. They saw where you were, and if you kept walking straight, you ended up in Heaven. So, you know, we see that... eventually Riceman did end up in Heaven anyway, thanks to that bullet from Dingo Baby, but that felt predictable. Didn't feel like a great call coming out from them there.
Yeah, I would have loved to see them take off angles instead, or, you know, try to, like, one tree, one Heaven. I think that works out there. They were able to get one kill, but then, I mean, you saw they both peeked into Hell, but then they're like, oh, there's no one there. And then it's like, surprise, here's a breach. Dingo Baby here at your service to get one of those kills. And now Monkler State, they've taken a second round, but can they capitalize off of it?
Oh, looks like they're going to see a little bit of momentum already. Ionly Vayne taken out. Divine finding one kill. Joe playing patient, as always, misses that operator shot as he tries to get out of the way of the flash, but he just can't do that either. Going to be pushed in by two, it seems, but now, okay, never mind. I had my angles mixed up there just a little bit. The Hunter's Fury able to find Swole Dominus Wrecked, and LEC picks up Divine. They have the momentum. They have that tempo for just a moment, and then they lose it seemingly just as fast. UC Davis, I mean, they've got the lead once again. They still have that operator online, but it looks like they're going to go full Bladestorm here. Flumi is taken out, and it looks like Joe did pop that Bladestorm, but no usage came out.
Yeah, has it online, still just trying to break the door. They're going to dash out, and this is interesting because they use the Omen Teleport on the point so they know there's someone in Hell. They do get the kill this time, and now they're just going to completely zone out Riggs, who is so far away from the spike.
It's always Riggs. I feel he's always the last one alive. He actually gets two, finds three. Riggs, do it. Do it. Make it a 4K. You've got that operator. I would love to see this happen. The spike's already planted, so now he knows the Silva has to go for it as well. Has to commit and misses the shot. Willie, with a 3K of their own, gets that shot onto Riggs, gets that round win, and that is a guaranteed lead for UC Davis going into halftime.
Riggs almost had one of the best solo carries I've ever seen. Yeah, the Molly on the spike twice now, that's gotten a kill. I can't believe this worked more than once. But more importantly, was able to shut down the Bladestorm as they got approached. And then I think the biggest thing is they just were a little too quick with the orbital strike. I think if they had been a bit more patient, a bit closer to the point, I don't know if they could hear the spike diffuse actually going through. I don't know, like, where, you know, what the sound barrier is for that, but they just kind of used it right away. And that gave really enough time to kind of step off of it, or at least get it to halfway. And then they just waited for the, you know, the peak to come, and now the operator goes back into their hands as well. So overall, great round for UC Davis too.
Yeah, definitely a great round for UC Davis too. Like you said, they get that operator and they have that Odin online as well. I mean, that's already so much firepower just between those two guns, let alone the three other weapons they have on their teammates. It's going to be a short buy coming out from our attackers as well, but Riggs going to make that pay off a little bit more. Able to find LEC. Looks like they're going to pick Flumies. It's going to grab the weapon as well, who is currently still sitting at 0-9, so definitely not their game so far. Riceman finding Divine, going to tie things back up for eliminations, and Joe just kind of pot-shotting into the clouds here, trying to find a shot, but Riceman patiently waiting as well around this corner. Looks like he's going to walk right up behind Flumies, and he's going to be able to find him. Riggs, however, does get that Vengeance kill. Takes him out with the Spectre. Willie has that Odin, able to find one. Ionly Vayne finds another. Dingo Baby versus the world here, gonna be able to find Ionly Vanius. Dang, a long distance Spectre kill. That's not something I expected to see there.
Yeah, and while you only have a Spectre, I mean, look at the health bars right now on the side of UC Davis 2. They are barely living on a prayer right now, so this is actually a very winnable 1v2.
Yeah, Joe is probably one bullet from death. I mean, you just have to shoot his body a little bit. You don't even have to get the kill. But Dingo Baby is gonna be able to swap onto that Vandal. 30 seconds to plant the spike, and he doesn't even have it, but he is able to find Joe. There is a world where this is doable, but I mean, this is going to be tough.
Yeah, I mean, it's a big misplay from Joe. If you've got the op going to take the longest sight line possible, only 15 seconds left. They're gonna they know there's someone in the boathouse. Oh, this is gonna be an epic showdown.
Oh, Dingo Baby, how somehow, some way, able to clutch it up there, finds Willy with the elimination. That was scary for a second, but he got a great flash there.
Yeah, but
oh, he got the operator.
Yeah, got the operator as well.
I didn't notice.
Yeah, took it away from Joe, and I think that comes down to just Joe completely misplaying that situation.
Yeah, for sure.
You should be the one in Boathouse, and you should have Willy be way more up front if possible. But there, everything lines up for Montclair State, and while they can't get a lead going into this, if they get the next two rounds, and that's a very nice, you know, round total going into halftime, especially on a defensive side of the map.
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt. If you're able to get the score up just a little bit. I mean, if we see UC Davis take these next couple of rounds in a halftime, that'll of course put them 9-3, which is quite the deficit. But like you said, 5-7, like that's winnable. Like you can come back from that. LEC, however, gonna make it a lot harder to win this round as they take Flumies out of the fight instantaneously with the Bucky. Willy finds Divine as well. Dingle Baby Joe finds another one, and all of a sudden the Bucky round of a lifetime.
Talk about
thrifty. I couldn't have said it better. That was UC Davis just did what is seemingly impossible.
Yeah, that was just two Buckies going to work.
That
they
was
also
just
get
beautiful.
They get two Vandals out of it. I mean, that's a round that Montclair State, they should have won that hands down, but they don't check their corners. They don't play patiently enough. They just decide that, you know, we've got the lockdown on right now, so why even bother? They just assume the point is completely cleared out. But you know, there's a gambit that's put down by UC Davis here. They said, no, we're gonna play here with our shotguns, we're gonna hold these close quarters, and if you can kill us, if you can stay alive after the lockdown goes down, sure, you can kill us, but if you can't, like they couldn't, that's an easy win for UC Davis and a thrifty one at that.
Yeah, and I mean, I could not say it enough, folks. You gotta check your corners. You gotta look in them, because you will die. You will die just like that. I mean, that is, the proof is in the pudding. You gotta be checking those corners. Now, I only Vayne committing to run it back, and he almost gets taken out by his own teammate there, but the Hunter's Fury does not hit him. Joe, however, does find Divine, so it looks like it's gonna be an elimination in favor of UC Davis 2, per the usual at this point, coming into this, what is it, the 12th round, I believe, of this matchup? So now we're gonna, yeah, this will be the last round before halftime. But now we see one elimination already in favor of our defenders. They're gonna try to find something early on, but the Killjoy ultimate coming out from the side of Riceman, so UC Davis committing their Killjoy ult, that lockdown, and I wouldn't be surprised to see Swole Dominance Wrecked. Actually, when did Swole Dominance Wrecked commit their ultimate? Because they're at 2-7.
Yeah,
2-7.
It was, I think, it was last round. It didn't work out, though. But now there's going to be a huge flank, and Joe only one away from the ace. They don't get it. I only Vayne.
I only Vayne.
Steal the deal, but I mean, look at That was a great play, but look at how many ultimates are still, like, there are three right now for Montclair State that they're never going to be able to use.
That's just got to use those. That sounds so foolish, like, just use
the forehead.
Like, but realistically, like, you've got to use those ults. You can't have them just sitting in your inventory. Like, you know that that's the last round to use them. Commit them. Commit them some way, somehow, because you just threw those ultimates out. Like, you got zero value from them.
And my question was going to be if they use the orbital strike on the lockdown, because that's a great way to break the enemy one.
Right.
But they never use it. They don't use it at all, and they go to the grave of that. I think they also had a Rolling Thunder online. They had a few things to use there, and none of them actually ended up coming to fruition. And like you said, that lockdown was the one from last round. They tried to gamble a bit the round before. It didn't work out because a great thrifty defense comes out. And now UC Davis too. They only need four rounds. That is not a lot to put this match away and then go up 1-0 in the series.
Yeah, four rounds at halftime. I mean, that is a good place to be living in. There's only a couple of better matchups there, and that would of course be going into halftime like 12-0, of course. But you know, 9-3, that is nothing to shy away from. And if you're able to win this pistol round and really flip tempo in your favor a little bit, like that'll be even bigger. Dingo Baby gets a lot of shots, but just cannot find the kill. Riggs, however, gonna be able to clean up off the back of it. Gonna be a 4-4. It looks like a Breach and the Jet taking down respectively. And the Omen on the side of our new attacking team, which will be UC Davis. Pressure's coming out on them because they are one bullet from death here.
A lot of people weak on the side of UC Davis, especially their Omen. Phoenix going to be caught from behind by Flumies, and now this looks great for the defenders.
Yep, Brimstone able to take out Sova as well. Riggs with the triple kill. Definitely that top fragger on the side, actually on the side of Montclair by a notable number, currently sitting at 15, most in lobby. Next in line for Montclair is 6 from Dingo Baby, so we definitely see a bit of a solo carry, which we usually talk about, probably isn't enough to win you matches.
It's not, unfortunately. Riggs, while having a great performance in their own right, has also died quite a bit. And then you look at Willy, who's down by 2 kills, the top frag right now for UC Davis. But look at everyone behind them. Everyone, there's only one person right now that doesn't have 10 kills, and they're at 9. So, like, almost everyone's at double digits right now for UC Davis, too. It's a great team effort. They do lose that pistol round, so it's not going to be a cakewalk to get to the finish line just yet. They're going to have to go through this round. It's going to be pretty difficult, knowing that Montclair State's going to have a bunch of SMGs on their side. But, I mean, here's the thing. You've already won a thrifty round with just Buckies. So, you know, doing it with a Sheriff in the Classic, that might not be out of the realm of possibility.
Yeah, and Montclair here, they're going to be full committing into this buy. They're all going to go for Spectres, so they're going to give pretty much all of their credits to do so their economy, and it's going to be a trade straight away. Riggs finds Riceman, but Joe picks up Riggs. So, although Spectres may not be worth it quite yet, it's Eye Only Vane finds Dinglebaby with the Sheriff. That's even worse for Montclair because they commit their full... This Divine is able to make up for it a little bit, finds Ali C. It's going to be a 3-3. We see six different characters on. Oh, no, excuse me. There's a jet on both sides. So looks like we're going to see 5 different characters as both still have their jets up. Willy going to be committing this recon bolt, trying to get any kind of info. But I mean, every second this spike takes is another second that eventually our defenders are just going to have to push in and pray.
Oh, this is a big thing for Eye Only Vane.
Oh wow, Soul Dominance wrecked, able to find 2. Eye Only Vane gonna find that Sheriff kill onto Flumi. He's a 2v1, and Soul Dominance wrecked is low, but Divine is gonna be able to pick up that kill. Oh no, Eye Only Vane finds Soul Dominance wrecked. And honestly, it's gonna be close, but I think they've got time to finish the defuse.
Yeah, they've got a bit of time. It was a very interesting, you could like just tell what Eye Only Vane was thinking during that whole like kind of little succession. It was, do I use this now or to heal myself, or do I wait for the retake?
Right.
They ended up going for the retake at the very end. It does get 1 kill, but it's not enough to kill both of the defenders. So even though they've gotten 2 plants, they haven't really led to anything. The good news though now is that they can buy for the first time after giving up a few rounds. It's a bit closer now, 9-5. You'd rather it be 11-3 right now and just kind of put the game away. But now this is where things are finally even once again. And if you start to stagger here as an attacker, that's where you let Montclair stay back into the game. So you cannot let them have this round.
Yeah, we talk about Valorant all the time. Pretty much every map is going to be a defender-sided map. You get a very small advantage, and just, you know, it seems like maybe Montclair's been waiting for this. Maybe them starting on offense, starting on the attack, just wasn't their cup of tea, but now they're coming in on the defense. They're already playing a little bit better, and I mean, don't get me wrong, we still see Flumi sitting at 1-13, so this definitely has not been their game, and everybody but Riggs in the single digits still in terms of eliminations. Ali C finding Riggs as well. I mean, that pretty much seals up this round for UC Davis, simply because Riggs is the only one really getting consistent eliminations.
Yep. It's the bonus round right now for UC Davis. It's something they were expected to win, but you know, it happens sometimes where they don't. Now they know where one is. They know where Divine is playing a little bit near tree, and they're not even going to try to contest this. It looks like they're just going to wait for them to walk in. I think the Killjoy is also peeking around the corner in heaven, so they know exactly where both of the defenders are from Montclair State, and it's going to be very hard to win this, and it's not going to be possible.
Yeah, at least you triple, and that's, what is that, the 4th flawless, I think, for UC Davis? Either the 3rd or 4th, I'm not going to keep track because I already lost count, but they've had quite a few, to be honest. They've really had quite a few in favor of themselves, and now, like you said, at one point you wanted this to be 11-3, but you lose a couple, you win that bonus round, like you said, they were expected to do that. Now they've got to keep this momentum up. They've got to just win, three more to win this, and they're able to win that first map, and then we move into our second map, which is Bind, I believe?
Yeah, second map. I'm gonna check my notes.
It's
gonna be Bind. Yeah, it will be
perfect.
Bind. So that'll be fun when we get there. I think you and I both have seen a lot of Ascent, so
yeah,
you know,
very
we're
much
able
so.
To move off of this map, but we still have a little bit more time here in Italy before we do so. I mean, if you want any chance of coming back from this right now, Montclair State, this is the time you have to shine. Last round, like I said, like it'd be great if you win it, but it's not the end all be all. Here, it's even playing field, no ultimates. Everyone, for the most part, has. I thought there was going to be a good buy, actually. It looks like right now Montclair State isn't really able to afford anything, so that's a problem for me.
Yeah, they've got 2 classics as their weapons, which forced a draw drop from me just a little bit. I mean, that is quite the risk to be taking, especially as Flumies. You're not really hitting these shots. You're not finding the eliminations that you want. And the odds of you doing that with a classic up against a Vandal, I mean, that feels incredibly unlikely. Now, Ali C, they're already going to get a super early plant. That's going to help. They need one elimination to really flip momentum further in their favor. And now Joe knows somebody's in heaven. He's going to possibly go for the wall bang, or I guess the floor bang in that scenario. But it looks like, yeah, a lot of patience coming out. Riceman is able to find Dinglebaby, able to find Swole Dominance wrecked as well. So that is going to be very, very bleak if you are Montclair. But on the bright side, I mean, silver lining, at least you didn't commit a lot of economy to this.
But you do commit the Empress at the very end. Divine just got it online and then pops it immediately, gets popped themselves. So, 10 have to You gotta read the room sometimes, realize where you're at. You're the only person alive, and maybe back in the day you could go for that 1v4 with the that amount of floor you had, but now you don't, and now you're down. This you can buy here, and this would have been a great time to have that Empress with the Orbital Strike, but yeah, Montclair State, they've got
two
to think
of them currently have zero credits. Like they can hardly buy into this round.
Yeah, if they lose this round, like it's game it's over for at least this map.
Yeah, that is incredibly unfortunate that we are seeing that aggression come out. And just from UC Davis, they took a lead and they never really dropped it. We saw a couple of rounds end in favor of Montclair, but unfortunately they have not been able to get back on their feet like we need them to. It has to be this round. Like Jack said, that's going to be the nail in the coffin here. I mean, they've really got to win this round, or the odds of them winning the final round are incredibly low.
And that's why, you know, having the Empress offline is just so detrimental to them. Because
huge for UC Davis.
Yeah, it's a huge advantage for UC Davis because, I mean, the ultimate bank is definitely in their favor. So it could have been, you know, 3v2. Now it's 3v1. And the lockdown is something that UC Davis can use now. They can save it for later. One thing to note is that this is probably the most passive they've been so far.
Yeah, very much.
Call it and it happens. There is going to be that lockdown and they're going to be trying to go on to A. There's the Orbital Strike. So this is what I was talking about before. You can use that ultimate to break the lockdown from Killjoy. And they didn't do it last time before the swap. They did use it this time, but that's the only ultimate that Montclair State had now offline.
Yeah, I was going to say that's the only one they had. And Swole Dominance Wrecked is one away from having that lockdown online, but going to be taken out of the fight before they're able to get it. Bloomy's already gone as well, sitting at 1-16, unfortunately. Not a great KD this time around. Riggs able to find Joe, so it's going to be a 3v4. But Brimstone already pretty low. They've still got Hunter's Fury on the side of UC Davis as well. So things are looking bleak for Montclair. They may be able to win this if they just are incredibly lucky and don't miss their shots. But as we see a lot of damage coming out, Riggs finds LEC, but the floor bang, I guess, onto Riggs is going to be able to take him out. Dingle Baby gone as well, and Divine will fall. That's going to be another round in favor of UC Davis too. And Montclair, they just don't have an economy. Like this feels almost impossible.
Yeah, I'm trying to look at see what they want to buy. I mean, we have one Vandal online from Riggs, and then a Spectre, a Bucky. Yeah, it's a Bulldog. Not too bad. I think the biggest thing is that they do have ultimates now because of those deaths. They do have some things online. You've got the Blade Storm, so you could just try to commit that if you're going to be Flumies here, you know. But you're going to go for the Bulldog anyway. The Lockdown could be huge, but the Hunter's Fury could break it. So I think if you are Montclair State, like, just use it. Don't think too much, just use it, and just as I say that, the Blade Storm does come online.
Yeah, Divine gonna be able to find two, but Joe able to pick up Divine off the back of it. So now we see the Blade Storm is online. I'm not quite sure where it ended up, and I'm colorblind, guys. I can't see the top bar, so I have to look at my tab to figure out what's going on. But LEC able to find Dingo Baby there, so a 3v3, and this is literally Montclair's last hope here on Ascent. Like, it's as simple as they lose this round, they lose the map, and we have to move on to our second one, which could, of course, be our final. This is a best of three, so if we see two in favor of either of these teams, they win it all. Flumies has the Blade Storm, picks up their second kill of the game, but Willy able to find him with the headshot straight away. A Sova, a Hunter's Fury, and a Dream. The turret going to be coming out here from Swole Dominance Wrecked. Going to be taken out, of course. And Swole Dominance Wrecked only has a Spectre, but is able to find the kill onto Willy. So somehow, some way, I mean, Montclair, they live another day.
And that was a big gamble right there by Swole Dominance Wrecked.
Very much so.
Yeah, the Spectre versus the Vandal, usually not a matchup you're going to win. In that case, you do. And I mean, your big trick right there, if you lose it, is like, oh man, I had this locked in. I could have won this 1v1 easily, but they decide to believe in themselves. It's a belief well placed. They do stay alive for another round, and we're getting a bit closer, you know, inch by inch, but already UC Davis is only one away. We'll see if they buy here. It looks like they do. So that they, you know, they're not going to wait any longer. They just want to put this away right now. The Hunter's Fury is still online, as you said, but that Killjoy ultimate still in Swole Dominance Wrecked's pocket, and that could what helps them fight at least one more round, depending on how they use it here.
Yeah, I mean, like you said, it's all really going to depend how they use it here. Like, that's what you need to be looking out for, because if they overcommit, if they put it down and it's immediately destroyed, that's not going to be great. And something honestly crazy to consider with a score like 12-6. I mean, Riggs is tied for most eliminations and actually now has the most eliminations in lobby. So that is, I mean, that's nuts. Just to consider that the team is down by 6 rounds and Riggs is still somehow the top fragger of the lobby. Like, that is just kudos to them for that. That is not an easy thing to do.
And the next closest person on their team, Divine, has half of those kills at 10. So that, you know, like, again, we talk about, like, you know, team play. Willy, Riceman, 19, 17 kills. Joe and Only Vane not too far behind, 14, 14. I mean, like, there's so many more kills. Right now, Riggs is doing their best to try to put their team on their back as the Brimstone and, you know, to help them get the first kill this round. So not dead in the water just yet.
Yeah, they are critically wounded, but not quite dead in the water. And now they just have to secure one more round win. They're up by one as Riceman was taken out. So we could see them win this and let themselves live another day. And as Divine is able to find Joe, that's going to be even better. Eye Only Vayne going to fall as well. And Flumies picks up another elimination onto Willy there. Looks like it's just going to be LEC. They are the sole survivor of UC Davis 2 for the time being. And Divine able to find them. And all right, looking good. Montclair, they pick up a flawless round of their own.
And think about all the guns they're just going to get off of that alone.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you mentioned this earlier, like you've seen a lot of flawless ends. That's the first one I'm pretty sure we've seen from Montclair. The other rounds that they have won, I've been very, very close. Or, you know, they've had a, you know, maybe like a 3v1 at the ends. But that's the first one where everyone stays alive. They don't have to buy. And all of a sudden, their alt economy is healthy again. That Empress that was not used very well is already back. So, I mean, obviously for UC Davis 2, you only need one more round to win. And you're feeling pretty good about that because you can still buy because you've had a very nice economy. But Montclair State has actually kind of brought themselves back into this. There's a world where they can win the next five rounds and bring it to overtime.
Yeah, like you said, there's a world where that's definitely possible. They're going to be able to do that. But just that constant looming fear of UC Davis, they've got to win one more round. They're not going to lose every round until that overtime. At least they're going to try not to. There's, you know, and it's possible that they're able to
don't
do that.
Cast the curse, though.
I was going to say, sometimes, you know, I'm trying not to cast or curse anybody, but it comes with my natural dialogue. So unfortunately, one of these teams is going to be the victim of a cast or curse. And I only Vayne for a moment. There was at 300 ping. So that is something to keep an eye on as well. Is maybe their internet's starting to act up just a little bit. And that may be why they've fallen to the wayside these last couple of rounds.
Yeah, that Phoenix is very dominant on the defense. Here on the attack, hasn't been as good. We'll see. We'll watch that story as it develops. But the story here right now is that Flumies is going to find the first pick.
Flumies, maybe the, you know, that bottom fragger on the side of UC Davis 2, maybe the very reason they end up winning this map, finding a second elimination onto Eye Only Vayne. So that's going to be good here. Trying to fire. I said UC Davis didn't. Know. That's the bottom fragger of Montclair. You'll have to excuse me on that. But Riceman going to try to tie things up right away. It's going to be some great aggression coming out. Joe able to find Swole Dominus wrecked as well. So things starting to look more and more bleak. If you are Montclair, UC Davis, they're able to tie up the numbers. But Dingo Baby going to put it in favor of them once again. Flumies able to find their third kill of the matchup. And now it's this Killjoy, a Vandal, and a Dream. We see two that are very low. Wow, you take out the most health first. Riceman's going to find a 4K here. I feel it. I mean, we're looking at Flumies is critical condition. They're going to have to get quite the kill. But they're running out of time, and yep, there it is. The clutch comes through. Riceman secures that victory, and all of a sudden, it is going to be over for Montclair here on Ascent.
And we talked about this a lot, how for Montclair State, they really had to keep using ultimates as they got them. They had the Rolling Thunder online, never came out. And that would have been a great position. I mean, obviously, it is a 1v3, but you got to think about that. Your Riggs, your top fragger, had like one health. I really wanted to see their POV because they looked like they were like, I was looking at their health bar and like there wasn't even red. It was just like gray, right. But they were still alive. So it must have been like one or two health. Then also your Jet is still pretty weak. She's in the red. So there's only one of you that's like somewhat full health, and it's the one defusing the spike. Immediately you are vulnerable. No one is there to help you. If you just use the Rolling Thunder there, you can knock up that Killjoy and stay alive, get another round, and then it's 12-8 and things get closer and closer. But there at the end of the day, they had like three or four ultimates. I think most of them were gained after they had died because of the death orb they get from it, but still so much utility that they had online that was not used. And I think that's a big part of why Montclair State is going to drop the first map here.
Absolutely. Just ult usage just did not work out in their favor. Like, it was just pretty not great. But of course, as we jump into this very small break, maybe they can think that over, talk about their strategies, and look to improve. I also think we're probably going to see a different comp from them, but we can talk about that when we get back. Check your posture, drink some water, and we'll see you guys in just a couple of minutes. We'll be right back.
What sound experience would you like today?
I'll have the Fantasy Pack.
Good choice.
And could you make it a Cloud 2 wireless?
On his way, sir.
Sounds amazing.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back. If you're just now joining us, it's UC Davis 2 up against Montclair. So definitely keep an eye on the fact that UC Davis, they win that first one rather convincingly. Montclair, they're able to come back just a little bit, but on ascent, UC Davis 2, they had pretty much a stranglehold for majority of that matchup.
Yeah, especially on their defense. It just looks like it was lights out. They struggled a bit more on the attack, which is which they will be starting on for buying. So we'll see if that's a trend that continues, if their attack isn't as strong. But I believe 13-7 was that final scoreline. And although there were some moments, like you said, for Montclair to come back, weren't able to do it. And this is a reminder for those who weren't here at the beginning of this game. This is a rematch from the preseason. Montclair, they're still trying to find their first win. For the regular season, they lost in the preseason. They have not won at all in the regular season. So this would be a huge momentum shift if they were able to win this matchup. The only way they'll be able to do that now is through a reverse sweep.
Yeah, like you said, a reverse sweep is going to have to come through here. We saw a map 3 earlier on today before Jag and I were online. You guys with Orbital and Analyst saw them go all the way to map 3 in that last matchup. And honestly, I think something that we talked about very early on is we're just not seeing ultimate usage coming out from Montclair. They have so many ultimates and they just sit on them. And of course, those are some of the strongest abilities in the game, so you're going to want to be using them a little more consistently than we're seeing.
And I think that was one, like, edge of the double-edged sword, is that they were not using ultimates when they should have. But then also right. We saw Divine in particular, and, you know, we hate to just single out single players, but, you know, as a duelist, you got to be really careful about your ability usage. Was using Empress in some of the not most ideal situations. That's the best way of putting it. You know, they're using it when they were down a bunch. They're using it when they just got a kill, but the rest of the team around them had fallen. So we'll see if they continue to play on the Reyna. Maybe if they play a different agent going into Bind, that will kind of swap up their play style a little bit. But I think the biggest thing is, like, they can't be too overeager, but they also can't be too passive. They've got to find somewhere in the middle for these ultimates to come out. And ultimates are not the end-all, be-all of Valorant. I think gunplay will always be kind of the first and foremost thing that we see here, just click head, forehead. But those ultimates can definitely give you a big leg up, especially in situations where you might be down otherwise.
Yeah, definitely going to be just about the gunfights. Like you said, simple as that. Just click heads, and those abilities come out very often from Montclair. I think we need to be seeing them more consistently. The Empress not coming out at the best times. Flumies, I don't think, able to get out any Blade Storms. I think we saw one at the end. And honestly, speaking of Flumies, definitely not their game. We saw them doing a little bit rough on Ascent. I think they ended with like 8 eliminations and they got like 7 of those in the last 2 rounds. So they finally started to warm up toward the end of that matchup and they really started to put themselves back on the board. But now you've got to think, maybe they just weren't warmed up properly. Are they going to come back stronger here on our second map, which is going to be Bind? I don't know if we mentioned that, but coming into Bind, are we going to see Montclair maybe play a little bit more aggressively? Because if Flumies is able to hit these shots, that's going to crack that team wide open.
Yeah, and I don't think that you'll necessarily see a Jett on Bind. I think that Phoenix and Raze are the most popular duelists on this map, but you know, we'll see how it plays out. I think you bring up a good point, though. You know, the idea of, are they going to be warmed up or are they going to be a bit, you know, I mean, it's kind of the difference maker there. Like, you know, do you feel more empowered now that you're able to bring a few rounds back near the end, or do you feel a bit defeated because it wasn't close for a very long time? But as these picks do come through, we actually are going to see a Jett online, but it's not going to be the one we expect.
Yeah,
oh, it is actually going to be the one we expect. Flumies is going to stick with the Jett. So this is very intriguing, the fact that we're going to see a Jett matchup on Bind. That's not something that you see every day.
Yeah, no, it's definitely not something you see every day. And not only have they stuck to the Jett, they've also now subbed in a Raze. So they don't have a Phoenix online anymore. If anything, I would expect a Phoenix and a Raze. But no, we're going to be seeing Raze and Jett versus... There's a lot going on here. We're going to see, I think, the same team comp coming out from Montclair here. I don't think they've changed anything.
No, I believe you're right. I believe this is the exact same comp. Meanwhile, UC Davis, they have made quite a bit of changes. Willy, who was playing the Soba, going to be going to a duelist now. Raceman, going to be going from that Killjoy to a Cypher. And now there's a breach. There's going to be 2 breaches. Dingo Baby was on it before, but now Joe is going to go. I believe they were on the Jett before, and now they're actually going to be playing the breach. So that's very intriguing to see like those role swaps. Again, roles aren't as important in this game as another one, maybe like Overwatch, but still, you know, the playstyle that you have can differ. I mean, duelists, usually they're supposed to be the ones fragging out. Controllers used to be the ones that are going to be helping you get on the points. Sentinels help get information. So there's a lot of different things going here. And now that you're kind of swapping up the rules, that can kind of switch how you play things up. I think really only Ally, C, and Ionly Vayne are the ones that are still doing the same thing in Raceman. So only 2 swaps. I guess not the biggest thing in the world, but we'll see how that plays out. And remember, they're on attack for the first time. This is where they struggled on Ascent more than defense. So... but these swaps, we'll see how it works out now for UC Davis 2.
Yeah, UC Davis 2 gonna start. Gonna start on that attack, which you mentioned already. They struggled a little bit more on that, and by a little bit, I mean quite a lot of it. We saw 6 rounds go in favor of Montclair when they were starting, when the sides were swapped. And now Swildominus Wrecked gonna drop to 21 health, and it looks like Swildominus Wrecked and Willy there, they're just gonna give up that gunfight, I guess. But Ionly Vayne gonna be able to find Flumies. Riggs picks up Joe, so 4v4 turned into a 2v4 in just the blink of an eye. Ionly Vayne finds Dingo Baby and Divine, just cannot hit those shots in time. Willy able to find that final elimination, and all of a sudden, another lead starting off strong for UC Davis.
Yeah, and I mean, when you see the same comp come out on 2 different maps, you think either like they're very confident and very good at these characters, or they aren't confident on other characters, which can be a bit concerning because you want to be adaptable in a game like Valorant. You know, every map is different. We always kind of meme about Icebox and how it's so vertical, but like if you do have to play Icebox, you got to come up with a comp that works best for that. And maybe situation that's like where you bust out a Jett and a Raze, but if you don't feel comfortable in Raze, then you're not going to be able to take advantage of the map geometry. Now, right now you see Davis too. They seem to have a pretty good idea of what they want to play with their swaps. And I mean, it's only 1 round so far, but they keep playing like this and they can have a much better attack than they did last time.
Absolutely. Willy bringing out the judge already, putting it to work, able to find Flumies there. That judge, that jury, and that executioner taking out that opposing Jett. Now we're going to see Dingo Baby go for a flash, but he walks right into another opponent. Riceman just waiting around that corner. Willy finding a second kill. And I mean, it's one of those blink and you miss it rounds. This is already a 2v5.
Yeah, a Jett with a judge is such a scary thing to see. She's just going to dash right into you and completely destroy you. Now there's Riggs, that top fragger from last game, who's going to be alive. But, I mean, there isn't that much they can do. They're going to leer out, but they're immediately going to get mowed down.
Oh, yeah, Riggs gone. Just another flawless round for this team. I mean, this has been nothing short of constant aggression coming out from UC Davis. They've already got a 2-round lead, but, I mean, this is pretty much a copy-paste to what we saw the first time.
Yeah, and you can kind of see where UC Davis 2 is in terms of the Challengers division, where they are in that middle tier. I mean, a win here was going to put them near the top of the mountain. That's what you love to see. And if you can keep executing plays like that, just running in with the judge can work out really well. And they've won a 3rd round. They won the 3rd round last time when it was the bonus for the other team. When it was a bonus for Montclair, when they were on defense, they were able to win that. So I would not be surprised with how they're playing if they can win this one as well, too. I think the biggest thing to look out for is that Riceman only has a Frenzy, but everyone else is Spectres and Judges, so there's definitely a situation where they can still win this and make it 3-0.
Yeah, they could win this and make it 3-0, which is exactly what you'd want to be seeing, I think. You know, that, of course, that's exactly where you want to be in, is I Only Vayne finds full dominance wrecked straight away. I mean, that's going to make it all the easier. And Willy still rocking this Judge, able to find another kill. Riceman picks up Dingo Baby in that back line. And as I said, still rocking the Judge. He did actually die and have it taken out of his hands. But we see Riceman is going to grab it. And again, blink and you miss it. We're looking at a 4v2.
And I feel like I cast or cursed that into existence, because the guns were so good right now for Montclair State. They all were able to buy Assault Rifles, except for, I believe, Divine, who does have a Spectre. But I mean, Vandal, that should win a matchup between a Judge any day. But the thing is that they're just letting UC Davis 2 push in so aggressively that they can't actually get those distance battles that they want. And then once there's a Judge in your face, we already said it, I mean, Pop goes the Weasel. You're not going to win that.
Yeah, you are really not going to win that matchup there. The spike being planted as well, and I just don't think a Brimstone and Arena this early in the game. They don't have a kit online. I really don't think they're going to be able to win this. They've got a Vandal and a Spectre, but they don't have the time to kill four people and defuse.
And I just realized it's the exact same agents that lived last round, Riggs and Divine. Yep. They both are alive for round two for the spike to go off. This time they do keep their guns, and I think that's really good for Riggs, who's going to really keep that Vandal. But for Divine, I'm a bit hit or miss about the Spectre. Now look at what's going to happen for UC Davis 2. They're going to go for a complete full buy. They're going to be able to get the Operator, unless they decide to best around of it. I was saying they really had it for just a second. Now they might actually go for a bit of a lighter buy. I'm not sure what they'll do, but UC Davis 2, the momentum, their momentum kind of stopped for a little bit on Ascent, but it definitely has picked up here once again.
Yeah, absolutely. The momentum has really flipped and stayed in their favor once again. They lost it for a moment, and Flumi's coming out on the Bulldog. You know, not my favorite weapon, but one that always gets the job done. As long as you're hitting your shots, any gun can be a good one. Flumi's able to find that elimination early on, so backing up my point. If maybe not the best weapon, but not a bad one either. And now we see Divine finding Joe. Riceman gonna pick up Divine, so that trade hardly worth it. You're still up in numbers just by one. So this is the first time I feel we've seen Montclair with a lead, I'm pretty sure, at all here on Bind. I feel like they've got a decent lead, they might as well try to utilize it.
Neural Theft being committed is going to also lead to a teleporter from Riceman, so now they're just going to try to go all the way around to A, but I mean, Montclair State, they know exactly what's up, so I think this is a really smart play. Where's the spike? It's with the Cypher, so I would say maybe give it to your Jet, give it to someone else, and then just try to make noise one place. You've already pulled them all the way to A, so this could be a full rotation to B, and then you can just keep rotating back and forth. You do have that camera on B long, so you know exactly if there's going to be someone rotating, but looks like at least for the time being, they do want to commit to this A site.
Yeah, they're going to commit to this A site, which, you know, very clearly has worked out for them a couple of times.
Look at this. Look at Montclair. They're all rotating now. They're going back to B.
Oh, and that's exactly what UC Davis 2 wanted to happen. Now, pretty much all of Montclair, they've just left point. Now they're going to be coming back, but there's not enough time to get back before the spike plant comes through. So now they're going to have that little bit of a high ground, and that's not necessarily an advantage. And a Soul Dominance Wreck is taken out by Willy. A 3v3, so even more in favor of UC Davis as they've got the spike planted. Looks like they're going to be committing a little bit of aggression here. It's going to turn into a firefight if one time or another. Someone's going to turn the corner right into Willy's crosshair, but Riggs is going to be able to find a double kill. Going to actually flip it in favor of Montclair. So all that smack I was talking, turns out I'm going to be the wrong one here. At least they're finally eliminated. And again, Montclair, they're able to put at least one under their belt.
It was a great diversion play there by UC Davis 2, but Montclair did end up wising up. And the biggest thing is that UC Davis 2 did not play split enough. They played so close-knit together. They all played around U-Haul, where you really need to have one on A long, because you know they're all going to be coming from B. So you had the tripwire as well. So if there was someone trying to flank, you would have been aware of it happening. But instead, they all play very close-knit to where the spike is, and from there, Montclair State, they are just able to kind of, you know, jump on that opportunity. They use the stem beacon, get some extra damage and fire rate, and win that round. It's a bit closer than it was earlier on. I feel like UC Davis was in much more control of Ascent, but again, we talked about how their attack isn't as strong as their defense.
Right. The attack is just not nearly as strong as the defense. Willy also just notably doing a better job than they did on Ascent, currently sitting as the top fragger in the lobby in 7 eliminations. The most other than that is 3, so definitely making a name for themselves a little bit. And they're already going to be committing to an Operator early on, which I think is an unusual choice, but I mean, if it works, right? If you can actually land those shots, if you can get the kills, the Operator, of course, is going to be worth it.
Yeah, it's a big risk, especially on the attacking side, but if it works, it works. Like you said, and you already mentioned, Willy is the top fricker, has been popping off on this Jet. I think the biggest thing is you just have to find an angle that works out for you, and right now it looks like they're trying to look into showers, and the spike is still left at A, so even though there's a lot of noise being made at B, they haven't actually decided where they want to go on this attack.
Yeah, we're going to see a little bit of indecision in both the teams. Really, nobody's, like, not all of one team is on a point. So we're seeing a lot of split attacks coming through here. Riceman able to find Divine. That's going to be huge. That's going to really open up B. We see one more defender going to be Flumies on the high ground. Actually able to, never mind, clean up that attack. So Flumies going to find that double kill. Looks like they're rocking the Vandal as well. So another lead coming out from Montclair, but your Jets, she's critical condition. So it's basically a 3v3.
Yeah, Ironly Vayne just goes for the blast. Pack tries to go like out from Hookah onto the point, but because of that, isn't able to hit the shots. And now, Willie, even with the operator, is going to commit the blade storms. This is a very aggressive play, but I mean, you're going to put your operator at risk.
Yeah, very much so.
Die too far forward and you're never getting it back.
Yeah, die too far forward and they're going to be able to grab it before a teammate can as well. So you definitely want to try to get that operator, maybe even drop it to a teammate before you commit this. I mean, this just feels so weird.
Yeah, I was gonna say, just leave it behind. Maybe try to pick up. There's so many Vandals on the ground, so why not?
Right. Maybe just leave it somewhere that it can be grabbed by a teammate. If you go down just like that, Willie's gonna biff all the shots. Swole Dominus wrecked. Able to find a little bit more damage. LEC finds Riggs. It's gonna be a 1v1. Killjoy versus an Omen here. This really does not get closer. We see 70 for LEC and Swole Dominus wrecked with the triple kill. Gonna secure quite a few eliminations for themselves there. I believe three, if I'm not mistaken, maybe only two, but they also get that operator. We talked about it. High risk, no reward there for UC Davis.
Yeah, I mean, if you're gonna commit the Blade Storm, just drop the operator off somewhere. Yeah. Try to throw it off a map if possible. You're playing so up close. You saw them going to it for just a second, trying to take that angle, and it didn't work out. And I think what we got right now is, you know, they're just saying, hey, I'm Flumies and I'm the Jet, so give me that up. And that's what happened there.
Just waiting, just patiently waiting for that operator to be dropped. That was quite funny.
Yeah, and eventually it is. It was a big risk, no reward, as you said. And now that's a lot of value going the way of Montclair. And this is the closest they've been to an even game. I mean, it's only one round away from being tied.
I was gonna say, talk about value. I mean, they've got an operator thanks to the sloppiness of their team or their opponents, and now they've got four ultimates. Riggs is one kill away from the fifth. Use some of these, you know? You're only five rounds in, using maybe that Empress or maybe using the lockdown, like that could really flip around in your favor. And like you said, you're one round away from tying it up. It's like, you really want to win this.
Empress was committed. Alarmbot did find out some information for Swole Dominus Rex as they had to leave U-Haul, and I don't know if they know there's two people right around the corner, but there definitely is. I want to know where the spike is. It looks like they're just gonna go for this early plant, and now the whole fight is on.
Oh, and Joe gonna be taken out very early on by Riggs here, and they're gonna try to stun the people planting the spike, just not able to do it quite yet. So the spike plant, like you said, it comes through, but you know,
Rolling
I think
Thunder.
There's just a lot of patience coming out here. Divine able to find Riceman, so even more in favor of Montclair here. LEC is going to pick up Riggs, but Swole Dominus Wrecked finds another one. LEC with a double kill, Willy with a third. All of a sudden, it's going to be tied up here. LEC, however, they are critical condition. And Flumi is still rocking that operator, but they too are going to commit a Blade Storm and be taken out right away. I don't know what is going on with that, but I mean, LEC with the triple kill, 21 health. They're able to secure another round win.
I think there was just...
Or a lot of misplays.
It was Flumies jumping right in with the Blade Storm. Flumies and Willy just kind of...
Every single knife.
Had that, like, bruh moment where they just kind of were staring at each other. It's kind of like... it's like the Spider-Man meme where they're pointing at each other.
Yeah.
But the thing is, yeah, like, the Blade Storm, like, it's great if you can hit your headshots. But other than that, like, it's so easy to whiff on it. There, unfortunately, they miss everything. Willy does get the trade. But the fact that Willie dies and they know exactly it's from behind, then it's just gonna completely key in LEC that there's someone coming from that direction. Even though they had like 20 health, they're able to hit all their shots, and that's a round that Montclair should have won, but UC Davis,
yeah,
they're able to pull it off, and the lead is still in their favor.
And if I'm not mistaken, I don't think anybody grabbed the... Oh, no, I'm just kidding. Willy does have that operator, so they were able to grab that there. We see Divine taken out straight away. Flumi's able to find Ionly Vayne, but going to be taken out by LEC, who just... I mean, just such a silent hero right now. LEC always finding these eliminations when they're most crucial, always picking up these kills when they're most important, because it got tied up. LEC, they're able to find one more elimination onto Flumi's, so things are going to get all rocked up.
Rolling Thunder committed on to B to completely clear out the point. Good ult, but they don't know that there is no one there. But now Riceman going to be on the flank trying to clean this up. And I'm not sure what's going on right now. So Dominus Rex.
I believe they lost power. I'm seeing that in the chat. It seems. Yeah, no. It looks like they did lose power. So we see a little bit of a disconnect. And they're even telling him where he's standing so they can kill them and pause the round. So we are going to be jumping into a quick pause. Swole Dominus Rex, unfortunately. I believe they said lost power or lost internet. And yeah, as I hold tab, I see that they have completely disconnected from the match, unfortunately. So I think there's a 10-minute timer in place. And then once that 10 minutes is hit, I think it turns into a forfeit, unfortunately, for Montclair in favor of UC Davis. And here they come around the corner with a shotgun, I believe. Willy just staring Swole Dominus wrecked in the face.
Patiently, they are patiently waiting, and it looks like they have found him. And yeah, okay, the spike plant comes through. Easy win. Soldominus Rekt has unfortunately disconnected, which I assume throws us into that timer of, are they going to be able to come back in time?
Yeah, should. Yeah, there's the pause. I think one thing that was actually nice about that is they didn't kill them, because, you know, that would make their KD a little worse. Right. And the spike was already pretty close to going off, so nice sportsmanship there, UC Davis.
Pretty
too.
Much
I like,
so. Good
I
job.
Like that a lot. I mean, the hope right now, right, is that we can get this Killjoy player back in the lobby very soon. But if that doesn't happen, things can go unfortunate for Montclair. They don't have the most money either. It looks like Soldominus, because they didn't die, actually. Here's the counterpoint of that. Because they didn't die, they didn't get more money. So they would have to go for a light buy if they wanted to get an assault rifle. They'd have to go for a light shield, and maybe they could get a Phantom or a Vandal, but... such is the cost of living, I guess, in a world like this, in the world of Valorant. Everyone else can buy, but just puts you in a bit of a pickle,
tough spot.
I would say.
Yeah, a tough spot for sure. And not to be that guy, but if Soldominus Rekt is not able to return, that will actually put us very close to right back on schedule, which would be great, because after that very extended map 3 earlier, it has thrown us off schedule by quite a bit. So now, you know, maybe if they don't return, maybe it is just how one would say, how the cookie crumbles. And unfortunately, you know, that would be another loss on board for Montclair, and nobody wants to lose due to a disconnect, but it looks like we are going to see Soldominus Rekt return, so they're going to be bringing the heat per the usual. Hopefully their internet able to stabilize.
Yeah, it looks like they are back in action, or at least the timer has been on pause. We did see some movement, have not bought anything beyond a...
I'm not sure they're back.
Goldfield, yeah, and there it is. Okay, so they're bringing out the pressure to play. It looks like they are back, but I mean, the biggest thing is that Willie does get the operator. And already two kills coming out for UC Davis.
Yeah, that's going to be great. UC Davis, they're coming back hotter than ever. They're able to take out both Flumies and Divine, so a 5v3. The operator still online for Willy as well, bringing the heat. And honestly, this is surprisingly for being nearly 8 rounds in, we are not seeing a lot of eliminations like for one person. We're seeing a lot more consistent across the board. The lowest on both teams is going to be 2 from Montclair and 3 from UC Davis. But nobody's sitting at 0 this time, which is great.
I mean, it's the same thing for UC Davis, right? I mean, 9-8-6, those are the top 3 fraggers on their side. That's going to make it a little bit closer. Now it's 9-9. Now there's only Soldominus Rekt left, and now they're gone. It's a very fast round win.
That was a very fast round, yeah.
I mean, they're just spreading love. I will say for Montclair, it's also kind of the same, but they just haven't had as many kills because they aren't winning as many rounds. But Soldominus Rekt, despite disconnecting, is currently the top fragger right now for Montclair State. Riggs, who is that huge carry in the Brimstone before, is only... 1 kill behind. Flumi's also, you know, doing a bit better off the beginning, but I mean, it doesn't matter if you're doing a little bit better as a team when you're still not winning rounds, because as you see, again, we were in a very similar situation where UC Davis too is already one round away from taking a guaranteed lead going into halftime.
Yeah, that guaranteed lead, I mean, that's a terrifying thing to be going up against. We saw last time they were able to take it to what they wanted to halftime, 9-3 last time. So we see this is something that they're very comfortable with, and hopefully they're able to keep this momentum. And Ali C with the operator, I mean, they have really been making a name for themselves here in this round. We saw a lot of great value. They're tied for top. Actually, they are technically top fragger because they've died less than Willy. I just, Soldominus Rekt is hanging out with the Sheriff right now. That just makes me a little bit nervous, but hopefully, yeah, you're not gonna win a 1v1 against a Judge if you're just rocking a Sheriff like that. So it's gonna be a 3v5 as Willy able to find 2 kills. Divine and Riggs gonna tie it up, 5v3 to 3v3. Ionly Vayne using that Vandal to find not 1 but 2 eliminations onto Divine and Flumies. It's gonna be Riggs against the world all over again, and he's got just a Judge to his name.
And what was really interesting there is that Willie was like, you know what, I'm just gonna go in with the Judge. It's already worked out before. I'm gonna do it again here.
Oh,
Ali C. Take my operator, and that's what I wanted to see for them before when Willy went in with the Bladestorm. This time they do it. This time Willy does get some kills and does die, but Ali C keeps that operator the entire time, gets a kill, believe, off of it as well. And you know, some of the stuff we were talking about before, UC Davis too, they're cleaning it up on the fly. It's huge, and again, we're going to see that operator battle as Flumi's now going to get one of their own for the first time, I believe.
Yeah, and honestly, Willy dying is so much less important because they dropped that operator. Like, it's really as simple as that. You gave the operator away, go ahead, go die for the cause. Like, it matters so much less, especially if you're going in getting 1-2 eliminations like that. So
if you're trading,
honestly,
if you're trading 2-for-1, it works really. If you're trading 2-for-1, it works out so well. Like, it's totally fine.
Yeah, absolutely. And Willy has that Bladestorm online, so maybe they go ahead and do that this time around. There's only one way to find out, of course. The ultimate's pretty tied up as well. We see Blockdown, Bladestorm, and that Empress coming out from the side of Montclair, and then pretty much every ultimate that isn't Breach is on the side of UC Davis.
And before I felt like ultimates were setting the pace, but I feel like in this matchup, on this map, it's not really done too much. Honestly, I feel like if you are the attackers, like, you can go for the Showstopper. We haven't really seen that come out to play just yet. But the Bladestorm, Omen Teleport, Neural Theft, those are all things that are more conditional. So you can hold on to them. If you're the defender, I think that Lockdown is the first thing that has to come out soon. So Omnus Rex, I don't know how long they've been holding on to it, but speaking of that Showstopper, there it is.
Speaking of ultimates, that would have been crazy if Lumis was able to hit that shot, but unfortunately wasn't able to do it. Dingo Baby is going to pay the price of their life thanks to that Showstopper from Iron Lee Vayne in the lead, once again in favor of UC Davis 2. They've already secured that majority going into halftime, so now they're just going to have to win five more rounds. That's not correct at all. Is it? I don't know. Don't ask me to do math, guys. Anywho, six more rounds. Oh, yeah. Okay, so Majo able to find Divine, and now 3v5, 2v5, 0v5, another round coming out from UC Davis. That's got to be the fifth or sixth flawless round we've seen from this team.
And now you've predicted the future, because now it is five rounds. So, I mean, you're just one step ahead of me and the universe there.
It's just that stream delay, right? Even though I'm watching this in real time, it's just that stream delay.
Just you're just prophesizing it. But I mean, exactly what I said needed to happen. They use the Showstopper. They get one kill off of it immediately. They zone out Flumis as the op. And they also get the Lockdown out for free. I think it's the biggest thing. So Dominus Rex tries to use it at the very end to try to, you know, bring that round back some way, some form. In the end, it gets just completely destroyed. And so is their round score as well as their economy. Not a lot of things going right now for Montclair State, unfortunately.
Yeah, things are unfortunately not going great for them, but it would just be great for us in terms of our schedule if this one did also not go to a map free, so maybe they're just doing us a very big favor. Who knows? Divine able to take out Rice Man. It looks like they're going to be able to make it out with six health, just barely able to make it out of the way there. So now a very small lead is going to be ripped away as Eye Only Vayne is able to find Riggs and Soldominus Rex. Going to take a lot of damage as well. The trade out finding Ali C, but being taken out by Eye Only Vayne once again. Going to be tied up and... I mean, with a six health Reyna on your team, we're pretty much looking at a 2v2.
Yeah, did they get... No, they were not a part of that kill, so no health from that. They know exactly where the operator is, so they're going to try to get them out of there, but they don't realize that there is going to be a Rolling Thunder. That's so aggressive, just using it right after getting it. That's the kind of play we wanted to see from Montclair earlier. Just go for it.
Yeah, that's a commitment and a half, to say the very least. Now Joe able to find Flumis as well. All of a sudden, something that was so close. I mean, a Ghost, I don't think you're going to win that matchup. It doesn't even get a shot. Joe able to secure another round victory. We can see them going into halftime 11-2. Wait, no.
10-2.
Sorry. Can't do math. I'm here to look pretty and have a good voice. I'm not here to do mental math.
It's all right. None of us are here to do math. Math is bad. Math, go away. But I mean, that's what I wanted to see from Dingo Baby last round. Like, they got the Rolling Thunder, just use it. This time, Joe, for the Breach for the first time, immediately just uses it. Knows like that, you know, it's round by round. Maybe they're not going to use it for this last round, so why not just use it then and guarantee yourself at least a 9-3? They use it. They throw it out there. It works out beautifully. They don't even lose the operator. Just so many things going right now for UC Davis.
Speaking of operators, yeah. We're going to see Joe taken out of the fight straight away. Flumis hitting that shot. Also tied for top fragger on the side of their team. So definitely doing a much better job here than we saw on Ascent. And now the Heat coming out once again. We're going to see UC Davis at that mild disadvantage. But that has not stopped them before, as we saw in that last round.
Yeah, I don't think anything stops this team, honestly. They don't care if they're down four people. They will just run in one person with the ultimate. Ooh. But Flumis now starting to come to life.
Flumis, come on, that is nasty.
Ace?
Oh,
ace?
No way. An operator ace, I will lose my mind. It's gonna be one more kill. Eye Only Vayne taken out by Riggs. I hate it. I wanna see an ace so bad, but Riggs is able to secure that round. So going into halftime, this is a very familiar score, folks. We saw it earlier, you guys did as well. 9-3 in favor of UC Davis.
I think the biggest thing though for UC Davis too is that they looked really clean here on the attack. That's kind of flip-flopping from last time, where they looked really clean on the defense. So my question now is, can they do as well on this defense and put it away, or will they kind of let that lead fall out from under them? That's exactly what happened on Ascent. They had this great scoreline, this exact same scoreline before, and then they just kind of started losing round after round. Did end up putting it away by the end, but it took them a little bit longer to get there. But here it is on defense, where I think their comp is even better suited, because, you know, Cypher's a defensive hero. Defensive agent, and I was really surprised that they were getting so much value out of that kit before. I think the camera and the neural thefts were really on point, but now that, you know, sides have flip-flopped, it's going to be even more valuable.
Yeah, very much so. A lot of things are going to be changing up here, and the momentum shall be shifting per the usual. Divine dumping in a lot of damage, but you cannot win a 1v3 like that. I only Vayne and Joe able to find it. Willie able to get that shorty kill onto Flumies, and Dingo Baby going to get that vengeance kill. Going to be taken out as well, and all of a sudden it is full dominance wrecked versus the world, taken out by Joe Honey there. And almost a flawless round, but we do see Willie taken down there, so not quite.
Great teleport there by the Omen, by Ally C. They realize it's just going to be B. It's a hard commit to B, so I'm just going to run through. I'm going to find a kill on the flank. It's also going to divert the attention of Swill Dominus Erect. Then they unload their entire clip of bullets. And then, as you see out there, as they were getting killed, they were just trying to go through the reload animation, which is pretty awful, especially when you kind of get, every bullet that hits you, you're going to kind of get stunned a little bit. So they're not going to have anything going in their favor as the scales continue to tip more and more towards UC Davis 2, and they're able to buy this round as well. Spectres and Marshals.
Yeah, the first Marshal we've seen in this matchup is going to be Willy with the Marshal, which is like a cheaper, slightly worse operator. And now Divine finding Ally C already. It's going to be great, except Riceman able to tie it up. Never mind, Divine going to take another lead here. Able to find two eliminations in this matchup already. Trying to find that Marshal, but not able to do so. Divine tries to pick up Willy, and they're low, but they are definitely not out of this fight quite yet.
And I love that play from Divine. Just tries to go in, doesn't think that anyone's gonna suspect them being there. They don't, but unfortunately just can't find the spray there. That's the thing about the Spectre. It has a really great high rate of fire, but it goes wild if you don't hit your first.
Oh no.
That was almost a bomb buddy kill.
Yeah, I've not seen a bomb buddy kill in seemingly ages. That would have been pretty neat, but Joe able to find a double kill. Divine finds three, but three is not five, unfortunately. And now another defuse coming through. The defense already looking strong. That's two rounds in favor of UC Davis since halftime. They're gonna be able to get that defuse, and this upcoming round may be our penultimate one.
It could be. It is the bonus round now for Montclair.
Right, so right.
It could go their way, but already we've seen that UC Davis can win in thrifty fashion, and they still have pretty good guns, if I remember correctly. They're going to have a Guardian, two Spectres. I think it's depending on what Joe and Riceman buy, that's going to be the biggest question marks for me. It looks like they're actually going to go for the Bucky, and oh man, do you remember what happened with the Bucky on Ascent? I mean, that shredded people last time. So
yeah,
that was
sad.
I'm excited to see what UC Davis 2 can do here.
You know, seeing the Buckies come out would be pretty exciting. And I mean, like you said, we're going to see them coming out. And it was a massacre last time. So maybe they pull out just that same optimization. Ally C, somebody's walking right into his sights, but no, misses that shot. Able to find the second one, already down to 20 health. But even if you die now, you've already got a great trade. You took out one. You actually took out the top fragger on the side of Montclair. UC Davis, they're going to be down one as Rice Man. Excuse me, no, that's going to be a tie-up as Rice Man is taken out of the fight. And now we see Ally C, 20 health. I mean, hopefully get at least one more elimination, but now Divine picking up Willy, things are gonna look worse and worse, but Ally C gonna tie it up again. The wallbang from Riggs again is gonna be in favor of Montclair. They are up by one. They've got that spike online, and they're gonna try to make the magic happen here.
And both players in the set of UC Davis 2 are playing Heaven. They're gonna throw the bomb buddy out. They're gonna try to get some concussions with the breach. Again, I don't think this is the play. I mean,
oh,
I'm
no.
Flip push, but they're just both gonna walk out and die. I mean, the Empress is out from Divine, and they were just doing work. So I feel like if you try to go for a push on the side instead, maybe you can catch them off guard. But odds are you won't win that round anyway, considering it's right. A 3-2. But at least you might get some exit kills there. They get none. The guns are still in the hands of Montclair. But on the bright side, now you can buy.
Yeah, like you said, there's a possibility to buy. There's an opportunity here to maybe flat momentum back in your favor. And I mean, UC Davis, they're able to buy, but hardly. Two of them sitting at 0 credits. The highest they have right now is 800 credits for Willy. And then other than that, they do not have an economy.
They do already have a Rolling Thunder. So I'm very interested to see how they use this, because I think this is a better ultimate on offense. But if you try to go for the retake once the spike has been planted, that can be a great way to clear the site. So I'm really interested to see how that plays out, but we've only two rounds needed. They might try to play it a bit more aggressive and just go for it before the spike is even planted.
Yeah, we want to see that spike plant come through. We want to see that aggression. And also, I want to point out that Joe Honey, I don't know how to say that. Joe on the side of UC Davis currently has 10 assists, which might be the most assists I've seen in a very long time. Currently sitting at 12 eliminations and 10 assists. So that has nothing to do with what's happening. I just thought that was interesting.
It's almost like they're playing Sage. That's what it looks like.
almost. It'd be interesting to see a Sage here, but now a lot of Breach gameplay today, which I'm excited about. I feel like we haven't seen him a lot lately, so it's nice to see him showing his face once again.
Rick's gonna take a ton of damage from that bomb buddy, gonna stay alive, and now this is where the Rolling Thunder could come in very clutch. They decide to commit, and you know, say it, and there it comes out.
Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be coming out super aggressive. It looks like Joey will find one. Riceman finds another, and this could be our penultimate round, but Riggs picks up one. Iommi Vayne finds two after it. It's going to be divine. I'm not even sure versus the world, versus four people who are not missing their shots right now.
Taking a little bit of damage from the blast pack, but doesn't turn the corner in time.
Hey, the exit frag! Just get the kill and run! Just get the kill and run!
Gets the kill, gets to keep their own gun, but no one else is really going to be able to go. Actually, no, they can full buy on the side of Montclair, and maybe not full buy, but they can buy.
Yeah, they can buy. They can buy a little bit.
But I think that's like a time where Divine has to realize, you know, I'm probably not going to live through this, but if I can stop the spike from being defused, if I can somehow help win this round, that's going to be a sacrifice that's worthwhile. Instead, they just keep holding that corner. They know they're coming into a lot of different fire, and sure, you get one gun out, but I think it's just kind of go big or go home. It's probably not going to work out in your favor, but at least, you know, die the hero. Don't live long enough to just wraith out of that fight.
Yeah, absolutely. Die the hero, don't live long enough to see yourself become the Wraith, or however that saying goes. Anyway, now it's going to be that 5v5 classic as the round just opens up, and UC Davis, they really want to try to not make any mistakes, because if they're able to secure the win here, that's going to be a 2-0 win, and okay, all right, you see, no mistakes have been made so far, as this round looks like it may be flawless. Flumi is that last survivor, does not have the spike, either trying to look for any kind of eliminations, might be able to find one, going to pick up Ali C, going to not be able to find Riceman, and just like that, my friends, UC Davis, they are able to secure a very strong victory. All in all, a great turnaround. And I mean, 13-4, that's a pretty nasty score. That's worse than Ascent.
Yeah, it's a better scoreline for UC Davis too. They definitely come out a bit more clutch in the second map. Their attack looked very, very clean. And as you see, three out of the four top spots do go their way, including Joe, who does have 13 assists when all is said and done. I love that Rolling Thunder was able to, I think, knock up two or three players when they went for that retake on the penultimate round. So great overall team play. Unfortunately for Montclair, their first win is not going to be found here today, and the revenge that they were seeking from the preseason is not going to be delivered either. But I mean, especially for Ascent, I think there are some good takeaways from there.
Yep,
I think that they actually did kind of learn throughout the series. They were using ultimates a bit quicker. They were being a bit more decisive. I think just their agent select was not the strongest. And, you know, going into different map types, you really have to figure out like what works best to the map's geography there. It's not the right comp, and it did not work out. It did not help them enough.
Yeah, absolutely. I could not agree more. And the comp was definitely weird. We commented on that earlier. We saw a Brimstone and a Breach, which, you know, I feel like you don't see them in tandem very often. You usually see one or the other. Not that they're super similar, but I just feel like you don't see them very often. But, you know, like you said, there's a lot to learn. Montclair, they end up losing that one, unfortunately, as well. But that's going to be a great VOD to go back and watch, because the rounds where they were able to win, there was some great strategy and some great execution from the players there. I think maybe they just need to not be afraid to spice things up a little bit.
Yeah, just a little bit of spice, not too spicy, but some different agents, some quicker plays on the moment, you know, when you're in it, just hit the button. Don't think about it too much. Try to go.
Oh, and use your ultimates.
Yeah. I mean, especially when, like, you got to know like where you are in the game. If there's like only two rounds before the swap, odds are it doesn't make sense to keep all five ultimates for that last round and then use none of them. So just have to be a little bit quicker on the draw there. But I believe, Septulence, that is going to be the end of our time together, but you will be continuing on tonight.
Yes, I sure will, Jag. This is going to be his one game of the evening here. I will be right back with Go Ask Alice. You guys saw her earlier. She's great, and you saw us together last week. We'll be right back in just a couple of minutes. We're going to throw it to a break, get our brand new teams in here, and we'll see you guys soon.
What sound experience would you like today?
I'll have the fantasy pack.
Good choice. And could you make it a Cloud 2 wireless?
On his way, sir.
Sounds amazing.